I will give floor to Artem Sukharev with next presentation. So next presentation will be properties of intraday variability of the radio galaxy Perseus Alpha according to coordinated observations in Latvia and Ukraine with a T32 radio telescope in the 4.5-8.8 gigahertz range.
Okay, hello dear colleagues, my name is Artem, I am from Radio Astronomy Institute of Ukraine, and in this report I will to tell about ongoing progress of project about study Perseus A radio galaxy and jointly in Latvia and Ukraine. Active galaxy 3C84 is a very large, enormous galaxy in Perseus cluster Abel 426. It's a galaxy radio source associated with core of optical lenticular galaxy, and galaxy gravitationally interacts with neighbors. There is some assumption that structure of moving filaments near a galaxy it's a diffuse structure, it's remnants of previously destroyed and absorbed galaxy. Also galaxy can be has jet precession according to long-term observation in radio range, because there is a typical wave-like structure. In this regards, there is assumption about present second black hole companion in core of this galaxy. So interesting structure of jet components, moving nodes in jet from Mojave WLBI team observation. There is no superluminal velocities in jet, and average velocity in jet don't exceed 0.4 speed of light. According to the angular motion data of the jet nodes taken from Mojave, it can be seen that Perseus A has many nodes that vary small displacement over time, little shifted, and they almost stationary, and only since 2016 year they are slightly displaced. It can be standing recollimation shockwave caused by difference in pressure in inner jet and outer jet part, or maybe stationary shockwave where jet is carved in this galaxy. So very interesting structure, and other galaxies from cluster can be have a similar structure also. In this picture showed a typical structure wave-like with two humps light curve obtained in Michigan Radio Astronomical Observatory, a telescope with 26 meters diameter, and this typical structure can be according to jet precession with period of precession maybe from 40 to 90 years. Because there is assumption about absorption of nearly large galaxy in past, there may be second black hole in the active core now. The WLBI map showed that the radio source has two wide jet component with complex internal structure, which were investigated in detail by radio astron satellite. In this work, we used three radio telescopes, two from Latvia, VIRAG, and one telescope from Ukraine National Space Facility Test Center. We try to study intraday and day-to-day fast variability of this radio source, and there is some information about intraday variability, but I can tell that when characteristic times of radio flux variations less than 24 hours, size of the emitting region is very small, comparable to size of full solar system. So therefore, physical nature of this variability associated with processes in radio source itself is often questioned, in maybe there is other mechanism of formation these flux variations, for example, interstellar scintillations or interstellar medium or refractive variability in large clouds in solar wind flow, and maybe acoustical gravitational waves in ionosphere of Earth. So there is a very hard question. And there is a present a typical light curve obtained in VIRAG. So in this plot, we don't see any flux variation, only noise track, and a gap in end of time series is shift of antenna beam pattern from source in end of a session, observation session. It's normal for this work. So taking into account 10 months of observation, we can conclude that this radio source has some phase of activity and calm mode. So this example, calm state of source. And in next slide, we can see typical records from Zolochev 32 meters radio telescope. It's a new radio telescope in Ukraine. Plot other it's after Del trend polynomial 3-degree trend, and we can see fast variations of flux density. Its sample rate 1 hertz, so one measurements in 1 second in this mode of work Ukrainian radio telescope. And also VIRAG radio telescopes has similar sample rate that make possibility to calculate cross Fourier spectra and cross correlation for data of observation. For data analysis, we used continuous wavelet transform with Gauss derivative function, and to verification results, we used autoregressive spectral estimation method calculated by least squares model. Two methods give quite similar results. One day when there is intraday variability, main quasi periods about some hours in this example, 3 hours and 4 hours, and also we can see track of quasi cyclical component with period about 1 hour, and also autoregressive spectral model we can see quasi cyclical component with period 1.7 hours and some minutes. So maybe all quasi periods from wavelet maps and after regressive spectral plots less than some hours maybe has made by moving ionospheric disturbances and maybe ionospheric irregularities, and it's not variability of the source itself. So there is examples of wavelet spectrograms, lines of quasi periods marked by a flux with quasi periodic time. We can see a variation of a plot of EFFT periodogram with line of phase, and we can see that when a range of phase changes in non-random way, this means that the found variations may be indeed present in recorded signals. Also, for better time resolution, we have used Pauli wavelet confirmed for more accurately determination localization of maximum on the map of quasi periods, its maximum over time. We have used dispersion normalized spectrum allows spectrograms to be cleared of background noise like radio variations. The example shows elements with quasi period of about 5 hours signal record in 20th of August. Very similar results were also obtained in Virac. There are no large no large volumes of quasi periods, but characteristic times on these variations most often in interval from 3 to 5 hours, less often from 7 to 8 hours. Multiple observation of calibration stable radio source show absence of such flux variation, which confirm these results, because our observation stable radio source has been not any variability, not any periodic variability. So in this example, records in 12th of December 2020 years in Zolochev radio telescope present quasi period about 1 hour. This quite interesting, and very often we recorded this quasi period in Zolochev and Virac in 16 meters radio telescope and 2 30 meters radio telescope. So it's very interesting results, but nature still not been clearly understood. Even at frequency of 8.7 gigahertz, maybe there is a free of ionospheric effect. This quasi period, about 1 hour, was clearly visible. Examples of records for 30 January and for series of observation at frequency of 8.7 gigahertz obtained from October. So this is interesting results about 8 hours quasi period, because in long time series of radio source, usually a false period, a period, it's a day period, 24 hours, but in this example we can see 8 hours cyclical component of data sets. There shown plots of flux density records at frequencies 5, 6.1, 6.7, and 8.7 gigahertz, which were obtained from September 23 to November to November, and from October 20 to November 2 of years 2020. Weak variations in the flux density in Janskich are visible. This periodograms for data from a previous slide. It can be seen that maximum correspond to quasi period of 8 hours at all frequencies except frequency 6.1 gigahertz, where characteristic time of variations was close to 6 hours. It's has been calculated for two circular left and right polarization. Periodograms were almost the same, showing, and long-scale Skargel periodograms method was used for non-uniform time series. Quasi period about 8 hours is a short set of observation from 23 to 26 September. Yes, at a frequency 5 gigahertz was also similar. At the same time, no day-to-day variability or inter-day variability has yet been detected. The change its mean flux of radio source within week or 2 weeks observations is no trend dependence has yet been found. Also observed flux variation with a characteristic time of about 8 hours were observed, for example, at the radio source 3C454.3 in a time series of observations carried out in Russia with radio telescopes of Quasar Wilbye network. Quasi period about 1 hour, also very interesting, because this variability was detected in time series from Urumqi Observatory from China at wavelengths 6 centimeters. So maybe it can be because in sometimes acoustic gravity waves in ionosphere can be disturbed radio flux, and modulate radio signal with quasi-periodic element about 1 hour. An optical part of observation. We use three optical observatory from Baldene, Latvia, Vigarlat, Slovakia, and Mayaki Observatory in Ukraine. Optical telescopes equipped by cooled CCD sensor and fully automated. Also, we have used data from private observatory of amateur of astronomy near Odessa City, Ukraine. The Schmidt camera of Latvian Baldene Observatory is very great for observing the variability of AGN during individual nights of observation. So observations of TC84 were obtained from February to March, and characteristic times of brightness variations in filter B, blue filter, what generally from 1 hour, 1 hour 0.5 to some minutes. There were also variations with the characteristic times of several minutes also was found. The most statistically probability of recording was obtained only on to March 18 and 11 of February. In the rest of the observation session, statistical significance of trigonometric approximation of the light curve was quite low. There is optical curves obtained in Ukraine, in Slovakia, in light filters B, V, R, and I filters, infrared filter. And there is day-to-day variability, well visible optical brightness variations. To refine values of quasi-periods and to compare them with previously results of other authors, scan for search quasi-periods with 10 of sounds test frequencies was used, and a possible quasi period of about 3.7 days with amplitude of approximating sinusoid about 0.16 stellar magnitude. At the same time, on classic Lomskargl periodograms, this period was blurred and practically not visible against a background of other peaks on a spectrogram. This slide shows trigonometric approximation of data sets with good clearly seen periods more than 10 days. This is all tables of optical variability parameters for day-to-day on the left and intraday variability on the right. Interestingly, a quasi-period with characteristic time about 1 hour was also observed in this optical light curves. There is shown 3C84 optical variability about some explanation about most common models of rapid variability of active galactic nuclei in the optical range, showing there but it's need to be not need to be there isn't consensus about this effect, and so far exciting theories and still under scientific discussion. During the implementation of this project, probably for the first time for VRAC, our research group used extensive international cooperation from three optical observatories in Latvia, Ukraine, and Slovakia, two radio astronomy observatories in Latvia and Ukraine, and one private optical observatory of astronomy amateur from Odessa, Ukraine. Evidence was obtained that active nucleus of 3C84 galaxy has quasi-cyclical variations in radio and optical range. Moreover, day-to-day variability in the radio range, trend changes in the flux density were too weak and not detected at the same time. No correlation was found between optical and radio data. At the same time, a large array of new observations in processing now, and we need to have some confirmations these results from the presentation. Thank you for your attention.
Thanks, Artem. Any questions, comments from auditory? Yuka Kalunki, please.
Okay, thanks, Artem, for your presentation. I have one question related to the calibration. When you are doing radio flux monitoring, the calibration is in very important role. So my question is that how do you realize the calibration, or either using an astronomical source or traditional noise injection, or both? Thanks.
We use both methods, calibration by observing a natural stable source like Cassiopeia A or Cygnus A, and also we have used a noise generator in for observations with a very fast sample rate, about 1 or 2 seconds between measurements. So we use two methods of calibration antenna, and also we have observed radio sources and try to make some periodograms for data sets for standard sources, and we have not been found any periodicities in the Cassiopeia A and Cygnus A radio sources, so can be confirmed really present of variability in Perseus A radio galaxy.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you again.